Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can convert matrix multiplication algorithm with C language code. So, we are going to implement matrix multiplication algorithm with the help of C language. So, I am going to write a function for that. So, let's say name of function is matrix multiplication. Its data type is void. It will be receiving three matrix as input. So let's say dimension of first matrix is 2 by 3. Dimension of second matrix will be 3 by 4. And dimension of third matrix will be 2 by 4. Then row one, R1 will be number of rows in first matrix, then C1 column in first matrix, then R2 and then C2. So these all parameters we require to implement this function. Now I'm declaring three variables I, j, k so that we can implement three different loops because in matrix multiplication three loops are required. So here you can see A matrix is having this dimension, B matrix is having this dimension, right? So 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. So whenever we implement matrix multiplication, we need to apply if condition to check these two values. So this is R1, this is C1, this is R2, this is C2. So we need to check C1 with R2. If both are equal, then only matrix multiplication can perform, otherwise not. So first of all, I am writing if condition. If C1 is not equals to R2, so we can write the printf statement. Multiplication not possible. And here we can write return. So return will be terminating execution of this function, right? So this way we added a check so that we can check whether matrix multiplication will be possible or not. So C matrix dimension will be 2 by 4, that will be storing the result that depends upon these values, row 1 and column 2. So here you can see we are having third parameter as 2 by 4. So these matrix we are passing through main function, right? So as per the requirement, you need to create first or second matrix, and then you can create third matrix. So we need to use this logic. And if you are passing your values as per this logic, then your matrix multiplication will be performed, otherwise not. Now after this, I can apply a combination of three nested loops so that matrix multiplication can be performed. So I hope you already gone through the algorithm implementation of matrix multiplication. If not, you can go to description of this video. So you will find link of a playlist that is data structures and algorithm video series. So in that playlist, you can find how we can write algorithm for matrix multiplication, right? So if you watch that algorithm, then you will be understanding this implementation in C easily. And also I will be explaining like how this multiplication performs. So first let me write the code, then we will discuss the logic. So here first loop will repeat row times back to first matrix rows, then second loop it will repeat column times of second matrix. Inside this loop I am initializing ij index of C matrix with 0, and after that I am writing third loop that is for k equals to 0, k less than. Now for this k we can use either C1 or R2, so I am using C1, and I will tell you why we can put C1 or R2. I will be implementing a matrix drawing, then you will be understanding how it will be performed. So now C of ij equals to C of ij plus A of IK into B of KJ. And then we can close all these loops and this matrix multiplication function. So this is the logic that is implemented in front of you. Now we can have matrix. So this is A matrix whose dimension is 2 by 3, so 2 rows and 3 columns. This is B matrix whose dimension is 3 by 4, so 3 rows and 4 columns. These are indexes. And let's say these are values. Right? And dimension of A and B are mentioned here, 2, 3. So its dimension is 2, 3 and its dimension is 3, 4. So we already checked this, C1 and R2 both are equal, so multiplication will be performed. So what we need to do, we need to multiply this row with this column first, then this column and then this column. So 4 times multiplication will be done. And every time you can see, we need to multiply 3 digits. So 3 digits are available in row and 3 digits are available in column. That is accessible through this 3. And this 3 is stored in C1 and R2. So that's why we can use either C1 or R2 here. Right? So K loop will always repeat 3 times. Now, let's say this is your C matrix. And its dimension will be this, 2 by 4. So now, starting from here, I is 0. So let's say this is value of I. Then we will move to J loop, that is also 0. Then we will assign 0 to Cij. So ij, both are 0. So Cij index will be 0. Then K will be starting from 0. K will be starting from 0. C1, so C1 is 3. So this K loop will be repeating 3 times. So first time it will be multiplying Aik and Bkj. So here you can see all values are 0. So A00 will be multiplied with B00. So A00 is this, B00 is this. So 1 into 1, 1. That will be added to Cij, that is also 00. So this will be 1. Now K will be implemented. So K is 1. So here you can see Aik. So this will be 1. Bkj. So this will be 1. So 01 for A, 10 for B. So A01 is this, B10 is this. So 2 will be multiplied with 5. So 5 into 2, 10 plus 1. So here also you can see this is still Cij. So ij both are 00. So C00 index will be having 11. Next time K will be implemented. So K is 2 now. So here you can see Aik. So K is 2. Bkj. So K is 2. So this is the value of indexes. A02 and B20. So A02 is this and B20 is this. So 3 will be multiplied with 9. Right? 27 plus 11. So it will be 13. So 3 times K loop repeated. Now it will be terminated and J will be incremented. So J will be 1 and K will again start from 0. And I is still 0. So this first row will be multiplied with this second column and its result will be stored. Right? Again this row will be multiplied with third column, result will be stored here. Then again this row will be multiplied with fourth column and result will be stored here. So this way you can see this row is multiplying with all four columns and four different results will be available here. Then same will happen with this row. This row will be multiplied with all four columns and four different values will be available here. So all these values are available into C matrix. So whenever this function will be completed, so the result will be available into C matrix. So you will be calling this function from main and will be passing these parameters. So you will be receiving input of A and B from user, and the output of C, that is multiplication of matrix, will be performed through this function. So wherever you will be calling this function into main, so main will be having updated value of C automatically after completion of execution of this function, right? So you can directly print the values of C into main function after completion of this function, and you will be having the output as matrix multiplication. So I hope with this explanation you understood how we can implement matrix multiplication algorithm into C language, right? And if you want to watch both playlists, those are related to algorithm and the implementation using C language. So you can find their links in the description of this video. You can follow that so that you can learn data structure in a well-arranged manner. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this.